Please get ready for a dictation of transcription number 158 from Sir Kailash Chandra magazine. 5 seconds. Start. Madam
Chairman, I rise to support the railway budget. At the outset, I congratulate the Honorable Minister for presenting a socio-economic development oriented budget for the first time by giving concessional and free journey facility by rail to war and police widows, disabled and industrial workers, awarded for productivity and technological innovation. This will certainly boost the morale of workers for increasing productivity. I am not happy at the second class fare increase. Due to financial constraints, the Honorable Minister has been forced to increase the second class rail fare. The second class rail fare should not have been increased, and the passengers should have been spared of this increase in second class fare. The Honorable Minister has announced several measures to modernize and improve the working of the railways. The railways are the lifeline of the nation. Therefore, the railways in India really need upgradation and modernization. We are lagging behind in modern rail facilities when compared to the advanced countries. I am glad that the Honorable Minister has laid emphasis on the modernization of the railways. Adequate funds should be provided to implement modernization programs. The Indian Railways have made distinct improvements during the first 3 years of the 10th plan. The Honorable Minister deserves congratulations for this, but many more works are yet to be undertaken, and I hope with the efficiency and dedication of the ministry as well as with the dynamic minister, the Indian Railways will make further improvements in the remaining years of the 7th plan. Sir, I thank the Honorable Minister for exempting goods freight hike in respect of certain commodities like fertilizers, food grains, fodder, livestock, pulses, edible oils, salt, etc. These are the essential commodities of common use. So this exemption will provide a great relief to the common man. Large parts of the country faced an unprecedented drought during 2007. The railways ensured massive movement of diesel, food grains, and edible oils to the drought-affected areas. The track restoration work in the northeastern parts of the country after the flood was also commendable. Despite all these hurdles, the freight performance of the railways has surpassed the annual target. The credit goes to the employers and workers of the railways for these performances. I thank the Honorable Railway Minister for performing such a challenging task in an extremely efficient and commendable way. Sir, 64 new trains have been introduced during 2007-8. The frequency of some existing trains has also been increased. There was a demand to provide track service between capitals of southern states and the national capital, Delhi. I am happy to say that superfast express services have been provided between Delhi and capitals of the four southern states, Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai and Thiruvananthapuram during 2007-8. The minister has given a list of some new trains proposed to be introduced from 1st May 2008. Now, I would like to say a word about computerization of passenger reservation. The government have taken steps in this respect, but it is limited to Delhi and a few metropolitan cities. I am glad to learn that computerized passenger reservation facility is going to be introduced at some other cities like Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Bhopal, Lucknow and Hyderabad. I urge upon the government to extend such a facility to Mysore also. I would like to say a few words about my state of Karnataka. Karnataka is very deficient on broad gauge compared to other states in the south. Therefore, I would like to press for a more rapid conversion of the trunk routes in that state into broad gauge. There is reluctance on the part of the trade and industry to expand their industrial establishment and trade. The broad gauge would provide them uninterrupted rail transit for their raw materials and finished goods. The conversion of Bangalore-Mysore railway line into broad gauge was sanctioned during 1999. The estimated cost of the project was rupees 26 crores. Now it has further gone up. The amount spent on this project is about 6 crores of rupees only. The budget provision made for this project in 2005-06 and 2006-07 was very inadequate. Therefore, I would like to request the Honorable Minister to provide sufficient funds for this conversion project so that it can be completed by the end of the 10th plan. I would like to say here that the people of Karnataka feel neglected as adequate funds are not allocated to the various projects. The people of Karnataka have been demanding for a separate southwestern railway zone. Recently, there was an agitation over this issue. This is a genuine demand of the people of Karnataka, which they have been pressing for long. The Government of India should take immediate steps.